Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it.
Praise the Lord. Good morning, viewers at home. Today being the second day in the month of July, Tuesday, July 2nd. In our open heavens of today, I pray God will bless all of us in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Shall we pray? Father, we thank you. We worship your majesty because of your faithfulness. Thank you for giving us the opportunity to be among the living today. Accept our praises in Jesus' name. Father, we are going into your word. Father, we pray that you minister life to us in the name of Jesus. At the end of everything, let your name be glorified and let abundant blessing be our portion. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Praise the Lord. Open heavens of today. Our topic says, at God's own time, at God's own time. The memory verse is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. To everything there is a season and a time, to every purpose under heaven. Memory verse once again, Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse 1. To everything there is a season and a time, to every purpose under the heaven. And we are reading the book of John, Gospel according to St. John, chapter 11, verse 1 to 21. Gospel according to St. John, chapter 11, verse 1 to 21. Now a certain man was sick, named Lazarus of Bethany, the town of Mary and her sister Martha. It was that Mary, which anointed the Lord with ointment and wiped his feet with her hair, whose brother Lazarus was sick. Therefore, his sister sent unto him, saying, Lord, behold, he whom thou lovest is sick. When Jesus heard that, he said, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Verse 5. Now Jesus loved Martha and her sister and Lazarus. When he had heard, therefore, that he was sick, he abode 2 days still in the same place where he was. Then after that said he to his disciples, let us go into Judea again. His disciples say unto him, Master, the Jews of late sought to stone thee, and goest thou thither again? Verse 9. Jesus answered, are there not 12 hours in the day? If any man walk in the day, he stumbleth not, because he seeth the light of this world. But if a man walk in the night, he stumbleth, because there is no light in him. These things said he, and after that he said unto them, our friend Lazarus sleepeth, but I go, that I may awake him out of sleep. Then said his disciples, Lord, if he sleep, he shall do well. Howbeit, Jesus spake of his death, but they thought that he had spoken of taking of rest in sleep. Verse 14. Then said Jesus unto them plainly, Lazarus is dead, and I am glad for your sakes that I was not there. To the intent ye may believe, nevertheless, let us go unto him. Then said Thomas, which was called Didymus, unto his fellow disciples, let us also go, that we may die with him. Then when Jesus came, he found that he had laid in the grave for 4 days already. Verse 18. Now Bethany was nigh unto Jerusalem, about 15 flocks off, and many of the Jews came to Martha and Mary to comfort them concerning their brother. Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went and met him, but Mary sat still in the house. Verse 21, the last verse. Then said Martha unto Jesus, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother had not died. Praise ye the Lord. At God's own appointed time. At God's own appointed time. When we look at the Bible passages right now, we could see that God's timing is different from our own timing. So, as children of the Most High, let us wait on God to know his mind at any point in time before we do any time at God's own time. We will not go outside his perfect will, and we will not be in an hurry to do things outside his will in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Our memory verse says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven. Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verse number 1. To enjoy your walk with God and avoid feeling of frustration, you need to recognize that God has his own timetable for everything that occurs in the life of every individual. For example, when it is time for a man to be rich, all his effort towards prosperity will be When it is not time for a man to be rich, all his effort towards prosperity will be in vain, no matter how hard he tries. But when God's time comes, regardless of any contrary circumstances, he will become astonishingly rich with ease. In fact, God's timetable includes the time of birth and death of everyone. When a person is not due to die on God's timetable, nothing can kill him or her. Yes. However, when the time comes for someone to die, no medical practitioner or prayer warrior can prevent it. Ezekiah's case may be sound exceptional, but then it boils down to the fact that God changed the program for him. In Isaiah chapter 38, let's go there, Isaiah 38. As children of the Most High, we need to grow in our knowledge about God's works. Ecclesiastes 3:1 says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under heaven. Let's read part of that Isaiah 38. In those days was Ezekiah sick unto death. And Isaiah the prophet, the son of Amoz, came unto him and said unto him, thus says the Lord, set thy house in order, for thou shalt die and not live. Then Ezekiah turned his face towards the wall and prayed unto the Lord and said, remember now, O Lord, I beseech thee, how I have walked before thee in truth and with a perfect heart, and have done that which is good in thy sight. And Hezekiah wept sore. Then came the word of the Lord to Isaiah, saying, Go and say to Hezekiah, Thus says the Lord, the God of David thy father, I have heard thy prayer, I have seen thy tears. Behold, I will add unto thee days, unto thy days 15 years, and I will deliver thee and this city out of the hands of the king of Assyria, and I will defend thee, I will defend this city, and this shall be a sign unto thee from the Lord, that the Lord will do these things that he has spoken. Behold, I will bring again the shadow of the decree which is gone down in the sun, that of Asa, 10 degrees backward. So the sun returned 10 degrees, by which degree it was gone down. The writing of Hezekiah, king of Judah, when he had been sick and was recovered of his sickness, I said, in the cutting off of the days of my days, I shall go to the gates of the grave. I am deprived of the residue of my years. I said, I shall not see the Lord, even the Lord, in the land of the living. I shall be old man no more with the habitations of the world, and so on and so forth. My age is departed and is removed from me as a shepherd's tent. I have cut off like a weaver my life. He will cut me off with pining sickness from day even to night, without make an end to me of me. Praise ye the Lord. So at God's own appointed time, this man was sick, and God sent the prophet to go and tell him, your time is off. You will not recover from this sickness, but you will surely die. But this man went to God in prayer. Our God is prayer answering God. He told God, I don't want to die. Face the war and commune with his maker. And God sent the same prophet back again to go and tell him that he has added another year to his year, so he spends extra year because he asked. The Bible says, ask and ye shall see. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door will be open unto us. So let us learn to take everything in prayer to God. As children of the Most High, we need to grow in our knowledge of how God works. Like Ecclesiastes 3:1 says, there's time for everything. Since there is a time for everything and purpose, wisdom demands that we seek God's face to know his will and timing, so that we don't run ourselves to death pursuing shadows. Amen. Matthew in today's Bible reading reflects the attitude that several believers have towards God's timing of things. She accused Jesus of being too slow to respond to their SOS call when her brother was sick, possibly suggesting that Jesus was not concerned about his condition. That was very characteristic of Martha. She always wanted things done quickly and on time. No wonder Jesus once told her in Luke 10:41, Martha, Martha, thou art careful and troubled about many things. Father, Father, Abi Martha, Martha, I pray the Almighty God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus. Obviously, it's most of us that are affected of this truth. We must have faith in God and wait for his time. Somebody said that it's time for everything. Even the Bible confirms it. Time to laugh, time to sleep, time to dance, time to mourn, and time to do all other things, according to the wisdom of Solomon in the book of Ecclesiastes. I pray the Almighty God will help us in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Unlike Martha, people of faith must be weary of the microwave style of living. It is not helping. It is not help situation in times past and cannot help today. So in the time past, microwave system was not working, and in today also it can't work. God is God of timing, of season and time. Abraham cut corners to have a son in Ishmael, and the whole world is still paying dearly for it. That is Genesis chapter 16. Let's read some verses there. What brought the whole world into problem today? Genesis chapter 16. Now Sarah, Abraham's wife, bare him no children, and she had an handmaid, an Egyptian, whose name was Hagar. And Sarah said unto Abraham, Behold now, the Lord has restrained me from bearing. I pray thee, go in unto my maid. It may be that I may obtain children by her. And Abraham hearkened unto the voice of Sarah. And Sarai, Abraham's wife, took Hagar and made the Egyptian, after Abraham had dwelt 10 years in the land of Canaan, and gave her to her husband Abraham to be his wife. And he went in unto Hagar, and she conceived. And when she saw that she had conceived, our mistress was despised in her eyes. I pray the Almighty God will help us. We could see now, my method, we always end in failure, in frustration, and in disappointment. But God's own way is always timely, and is always fruitful and enduring. I pray the Almighty God will help us to have that patience in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. That was very characteristic of Martha. She always wanted things done quickly and on time. No wonder Jesus once told her in Luke 10:41. Don't be careful. The Bible says, be careful for nothing, but in all things we should give thanks to God. Unlike Martha, people of faith must be weary of the microwave style of living. It does not help situation in time past and cannot help today. Abraham cut corners to have his son in Ishmael, and the whole world is still paying dearly for it today. That is a few paragraphs I read from the book of Genesis 16. Just a small advice from a wife to the husband. The whole world is paying dearly for it. If only he had waited for God's own timing. In spite of what he did, God was still faithful to his promise of giving him a son through Sarah. His haste act was therefore unnecessary. King Saul also offered a sacrifice which he was not supposed to be to. Because he could not wait for God's appointed time. And this marked the beginning of the end of him. I pray we will not run out of our time in the mighty name of Jesus. That is in 1 Samuel 13. Let's read a few verses from it. 1 Samuel 13. And some of the Hebrews went over Jordan to the land of Gad and Gilead. As for Saul, he was yet in Gilead, in Gilgal, and all the people followed him trembling, and he tarried 7 days according to the set time that Samuel had appointed. But Samuel came not to Gilgal, and the people were scattered from him. And Saul said, bring thither a burnt offering to me and peace offerings. And he offered the burnt offering, and it came to pass that as soon as he had made an end of offering the burnt offering, behold, Samuel came. And Saul went out to meet him, that he might salute him. And Samuel said, what hast thou done? And Saul said, because I saw that the people were scattered from me, and that thou camest not within the days appointed, and that the Philistines gathered themselves together at Michmash. Therefore said I, the Philistines will come down now upon me to Gilgal, and have not made supplication unto the Lord. I forced myself therefore. I pray the Almighty God will help us. That is the voice that normally comes when a negative action is about to be taken. So please, when a voice is telling you, do, make sure you restrain yourself. And let's read one or two verses more in verse 12. Therefore said I, the Philistines, and no, let's go to 14 and 13. And Samuel said to Saul, thou hast done foolishly. Thou hast not kept the commandment of the Lord thy God, which he commanded thee. For now would the Lord have established thy kingdom upon Israel forever. But now thy kingdom shall not continue. The Lord has sought him a man after his own heart, and the Lord hath commanded him to be captain over his people, because thou hast not kept that which the Lord commanded thee. I pray, no matter how hard the situation is, the grace to wait on God, the Lord will release on us in the name of Jesus. In order not to fall into the same error, we must receive David's counsel in Psalm 37, verse 7. Rest in the Lord and wait patiently for him. So no matter what we are going through, we must rest on the Lord, because it's our all in all. May the Lord grant you the grace to wait for his perfect timing. Amen. May the Lord help us to wait on his perfect timing. Are you married? Please wait for God to send you your perfect mate. For your perfect mate at his own time. And do not make your own choice in haste. God bless you as you wait for him. In Jesus' mighty name, say amen. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Our topic again, God's own time. So let us wait on God, because his time is always the best time. Our prayer point says, Father, please grant me the grace not only to know your timing, but also to wait for it. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, we are praying and pleading unto you this morning that you help us to wait for your own timing, not our own time, in the mighty name of Jesus, so that we be resource-oriented people in your vineyard, in Jesus' name. Thank you, our Maker. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Praise the Lord. God bless all of us in Jesus' name. Let's go to our hymn. We are singing hymn 8 today. How we go.
Thank you.
Let it rain.